Did your brother know that Julieta sold you?
I don't know because he was already in jail when it happened. But it is possible that he knew.
And he didn't do anything to protect you?
Kaloy never really cared for me. He even wants me to get into trouble.
Why?
Maybe because I'm not his real sister.
What do you think would happen if you meet again?
Sir, I will always be hoping and praying that I'll never see that man again.
Ina. Kaloy escaped from jail.
What?
Kaloy? Kaloy, son!
Hey. Seems like you're having a great Christmas here. When my life's in a terrible mess.
Son, how did you escape? Kaloy, where's Julieta?
Julieta's gone. She's dead. She's dead.
That's not funny.
It's true. Julieta's dead. She's dead. They took out her eyes.
Kaloy, don't do that. You're hurting him. Your father is sick. Don't listen to him.
Damn.
Why, Kaloy?
Mother! The police, they're here!
If they find out that Kaloy's sister is working for you, sir, it'll be a big problem.
She's not Kaloy's sister. Didn't you see how scared she was? And tell me, Mark, didn't you feel how sincere she is?
But, sir, don't you see? You'll be questioned again when they find out that Kaloy's family works for the farm. They must leave before anyone
else... They're not involved with Kaloy's escape from prison. And they didn't do anything wrong. I can't throw them out of here. If people are thinking that the Makaspak family is close to me, then he shouldn't have escaped from jail, because I'll definitely do something to help him be released. Don't you think that's the most probable thing that can happen?
Sir, I just don't want them to think that you're involved in this.
Give it up, Mark. I know what I'm doing. They are not leaving, and we'll see to it that Kaloy doesn't get anywhere near them.
Ma'am. Are you sure your son didn't come here?
Yes, I'm sure.
Well then, we better go now. We're very sorry for bothering you.
We don't mind, sir.
Men, let's go.
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, we'll go ahead.
Goodbye.
Have a nice evening, sir.
I'll go to Kaloy. I'll go to Kaloy. Gotcha! Gotcha!
Good evening, sir.
What do you need?
Sir, if it's not too much trouble, I would like to talk to Ina. Sir, sorry to bother you, but they won't let me in. They said she's still doing something. It's already 10 in the evening. If she's still busy, then I'll wait here. But please let her know I'm here.
What is this for?
I passed the training. I've been accepted as a seaman.
Really? When are you leaving?
You don't seem happy about it.
I'm not sure if I still want to go.
What? But that's the reason why you went to Manila and now you're having second thoughts?
Ina, I don't know where to start.
Start what?
What I'm going to tell you.
Just tell me, okay?
Ina, please don't think that I'm taking advantage of her friendship. But I've always... Ina...
David, I need to go. I have a lot of things to do.
Ina... I love you. What, Ina? Do you accept my proposal? Are you sending me away? Why?
It's not like that. But, you know, I really can't entertain visitors here, David.
Ina, I'm sorry. I thought... I can't help myself, Ina. I might not have the guts to tell you what I feel. Ina, all I ask for is a little hope. I'm willing to wait.
I'll think about it.
Okay, Ina. I'm going. Take care of yourself.
You too, take care. Bye.
Bye.
Do you have any idea who did this to you?
Yes.
Who?
It was Kaloy.
Are you okay?
From now on, you're not going to the market anymore.
It's my job, sir.
But Ina, can't you see?
Don't worry. I can take care of myself.
Hey, kids, your Sir Jonathan's here.
Good morning, children. I have good news for you. From now on, Miss Leah will be one of your teachers. Isn't that great?
Yay!
Damn. How can I get out now? There are cops.
Father, I'm going to school now.
Hey, buy me some cigarettes first.
But Kaloy, I'll be late for school.
Just do it. Don't want to drag attention.
8 times 8.
64!
Good! Yay! 9 times 2?
18!
You're doing great. Okay, clap your hands. Yay!
Now let's go to audition.
That's Leah, the girl I was telling you about.
Hey, I like her. She's a pretty girl. She looks kind. I really like her. You look good together.
Mother, here we go again.
Why? It's the truth. So, son, when are you going to propose to her? Hey, better make it fast. You'll never know. Someone might beat you to her.
Mother, we're just friends.
Oh, come on. Jonathan, what's the matter with you? Son, when it comes to girls, you're always like that. What do you want me to do? You want me to do it for you? I'll do it.
No! I am not leaving my post. You can file the case against me and I will answer all your accusations.
Governor, as your party mate, I've always defended you. But I'm afraid that the national leadership is suspecting that there's truth in all these accusations against you.
Vice! Don't tell me you also believe all these lies. This is going to cause more trouble.
Congressman Corona already gave a privileged speech in Congress. They'll investigate on the issue.
If that's what they want, so be it.
Governor, let's not go into that anymore. Let's resolve this between us. The council only wants a temporary suspension to give way to a fair investigation.
Fair? Fair to whom? Fair to all my accusers? And what about me? I will be subjected to trial by publicity. And I will not allow these lies to destabilize my government.
Governor, if you don't want this to ruin your name, listen to the people.
Gambling Lord!
We will clean up this mess. We'll fight this together. We will not let them defeat us no matter what. And I am telling you, I promise this. Things will get better soon. It will be just like before.
Okay. Hold that pose. There.
Yes.
Right?
Ina, you have a phone call.
What?
A phone
Who
call?
Is it?
How should I know?
Hello? Hello, who's this? Please don't call me on the phone again, David. If Madame Claudia finds out, I'll be in big trouble. Besides, why are you here? How did you get in?
I talked to the guard. They let me in. Don't worry, I won't take long. I really have to talk to you. I'm leaving for Manila. I might be leaving soon.
So, what do you want me to do?
I want to know if...
But David, please
Ina,
don't...
I know. I'm just worried. If I get to Manila, I might not be able to come back. That's what I'm worried about.
Don't think about me. You have to decide for yourself, for your future.
But you're more than that, Ina. Ina, you're my life. You're my life.
It's not that I'm meddling or anything like that. David, I'll let you come and go to the mansion anytime you want to. If you want to fool around or get mushy in the street, it's okay by me. Anytime you want. I don't give a damn. But if you're going to do that in my house, I'm sorry, but you will have to leave.
But, sir, we're not doing anything wrong.
Please, you better leave.
Ina, wait. Sir, I'm sorry. I want to talk to Ina in private. Could you please leave us alone?
David, we'll talk later.
Ina, we're running out of time.
Please let me go. I have to do a lot of things.
David, let her go. Leave her alone.
Could you leave us alone?
What did you say?
I just want to talk to her.
What did you say? This is my house. You're in my house.
Sir, David. Sir.
Are you jealous?
There's no reason for me to be jealous, Leah.
Angelo, I'm not blind.
Oh my, why should I be jealous over a maid?
I thought you're not picky when it comes to people you want to be with, and their social status means nothing to you.
Yes, but when it comes to love, that's a different story.
Why, Angelo? Do you have a different standard for the girl you're going to love?
I'm not in love with Ina. Besides, she already has a boyfriend. What am I to do? At least now I have a reason to stay away from her.
Here, include this.
See that? Where's the...
Didn't you ask me to throw it away, sir?
Is this what you're looking for?
Ina, I'm sorry.
You should have told me you're now sorry you were ever kind to me. I can understand that. It won't be hard to accept that. Because I know who you are. And what I am, sir. What I can't stand is finding out that you now look down on me. But I just wish you don't think so lowly of me as a person.
Ina.
Don't take my feelings for granted, Angelo. Because I can also get hurt like you. I can get hurt too.
Goodbye, Sonia.
Bye.
Bye, kids. Take care.
Bye.
See you tomorrow.
You know, it feels really great being close to people. The children, being able to give them something and seeing how happy they are about it.
I'm glad you're enjoying this.
I have a proposal. You see, most of the children of the workers cannot afford to go to school. We can do this for them.
That's a great idea. Yeah, sure.
Miss Leah, my mother told me the reason why you're wealthy is because your father is a corrupt politician. What is corrupt?
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to all of you. From your beloved governor, Eduardo Buena Vista. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to all of you. From your beloved governor, Eduardo Buena Vista. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to all of you. From your beloved governor, Eduardo Buena Vista.
What are we to expect from your upcoming press conference, sir?
You'll find out.
Thank you. That was Governor Eduardo Buena Vista, who's presently in the middle of illegal gambling and anomalous government transaction scandals.
Do you need something?
It's about Leah. She's the one most affected by all this.
I'm sorry, son. If only there's something I could do about this. But this is one big battle that I have to fight.
Don't you ever get tired of fighting?
I have to do this for you.
For us? If you were thinking of us, and not only of your reputation, you would know what to do, Dad. Whatever your decision may be, it's all up to you. I just hope we can have some peace.
As I built roads and bridges, I championed the cause of everyone, especially for the poor.
Long live the governor!
Long live the governor!
Now that I'm faced with this crisis, I want to be recognized as a true leader. I'll answer those accusations with my head up, and I will never allow myself to be suspended from office.
Long live the governor!
I want a fair and just investigation. That's why, effective today, I want you to know that I'm resigning as governor of Punta Verde.
What? Is he serious?
What?
I can't believe it.
I mean,
what's going to happen now?
No. He's a good governor.
I will let you judge me. I rest my case. I would like to take this opportunity to thank all of you for all the trust and support you gave me. I would like to apologize to all of you for all my shortcomings. I hope you can forgive me.
We love you, Governor!
Governor,
we truly forgive you! Please don't leave us!
Please
allow him to resign from office!
Please, Governor!
Support you, Governor! Please don't resign!
Governor!
What will be your next step, sir?
Dad, I'm very proud of you. Going to stop me? Do you really want to destroy this family? What?
Do you really want to destroy our name? Do you want us to be laughed at? That's what you want, right? That's what you really want!
Until we meet again, Eduardo Buenavista.
I'm sorry, sir. I can't tell you how I feel. It's just that it's rather personal.
There are things that you want to do, but you just can't. Questions that you want to find answers to, but there's just none. Like, how come my mother appears in your dreams all the time?
Since I told you about it, I've stopped having dreams about her.
I haven't seen these since I put them away.
Then it's you who painted this?
I've made a lot of wrong decisions in my life that I don't know what's right anymore. With my resignation, I'm sure my detractors are very happy.
I know you just followed your conscience. I know someday you'll see that things will turn out for the best. It's a pity. She's very, very pretty.
Every time I see you, you remind me of her. Maybe that is why I find it easy to talk to you. I can see her eyes in yours. Those eyes that mirror true feelings that just don't lie. Those expressive eyes, so trusting and hopeful that you can feel it. This was one of my last paintings. Long ago.
Where is she now?
I don't know. She's gone. She's gone.
Is that why you stopped painting?
Hi. Sweetheart, come in. Have a seat. Here, grab a bite. I'm sorry. I had no time to prepare anything special. You see, Jonathan didn't tell me you'd be coming over.
No, this is okay. This is fine. Jonathan told me that you make delicious rice cakes. It's my favorite, Mother.
Go to Ina. Ask her for some money. It's not fair. She's having a great time in the mansion while we're starving here.
She's not having a good time there.
Yeah, right, whatever. Just go there and ask her for some money. I need to buy some clothes. Look at me. I even have to use father's underwear. Go now.
Stop being silly. There's nothing wrong with this. If you think it's bad, well then you can replace them as soon as you get your Christmas bonus.
Damn. I escaped from jail. But this is no different. I can't even go out to get some sun. Come on, blow it. Blow it. This is for you. Take it. Isn't this what you've always wanted for Christmas? Take it. Aren't you my son? Aloy? Come on, take it. It's all for you. Come on. Come on. Go on. Heads or tails? Heads. Tails. You lost. Let's play another game.
Here, this is all the money I've got. I'm sorry, Mother.
Thank you very much. This is really embarrassing. But I don't know who to turn to.
I'm sure you know what I'm going through right now.
We understand, Governor. We firmly believe that you are innocent of all these accusations. And we are all behind you. We will support you all the way.
Yes, yes, we are right. Behind you, Governor.
We support you, Governor.
Thank you very much. Now that I'm no longer Governor, I have more time to attend to you and your needs.
Sir Angelo has been treating us well, Governor.
I have an idea. I'd like all of you to hear me out. I'd like to review all the existing policies concerning the management of the farm.
We'll discuss that during the board meeting.
Why don't we listen to Angelo? Who knows? He might be able to help us.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, that's correct.
That's right.
And that's actually one of my proposals. That we'll be more open with our workers.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Now look who's talking. Who works with them? Who spends time with them?
That's right.
Who listens to them?
That's not the point.
That's exactly the point. It's you who knows nothing. You don't even know their grievances. You know nothing of their problems. You don't talk to them because you don't know anything. You stay inside your office and you go out only on harvest season.
That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right.
And one more thing. I'd like to keep the line of communication open. To let them know what our plans are. So they can tell us what their problems are. And most important, I'd like to see if we can change into a profit-sharing system. The present system doesn't seem to work. Changing will make it easier for us to address their needs.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah,
that's right. That's right. It's about time.
All right, son. Go ahead and prepare the guidelines.
Yeah, all right. Yeah. Things are getting better.
That's good.
Thanks, Governor.
Everybody, let's eat.
Okay, nice. All right.
Come on, guys.
What are we going to do, madam?
This is all because of Eduardo's damn detractors.
Let's get them, one by one.
What? We will kill more people? And what do you think happened to Julieta's body? How come you can't even show me that until now, Pepito? We are in trouble, so don't make it even worse. And now I know why our relatives won't have anything to do with you, because you're damn stupid and your head is empty. Did you know that? Moron! Get lost!
Sir, I really don't know how to use this.
That's easy. You can do it with a little practice. Why are your hands shaking?
I can't help it, sir. Maybe because my hands are tired.
Because you work too much. Okay, let me show you. Do it like this. Stroke it. Gently. There we go. You'll be surprised. Before you know it, you'll be drawing like an expert. There.
So, you've turned into an art teacher, huh? And your student is a housemaid.
I'm just amused by this girl. She can really draw. Look, she has talent, see?
Is that right? But we are not paying that girl to amuse you with her drawings.
I'm sorry, madam. Sir, I'm sorry. I have to go back to work.
You should have done that earlier. The trouble with you is you refuse to sleep when it's time to sleep. And then, when you get tired, you complain. You know what? I'll never really understand you people.
You're impossible.
And why? Is this the reason why you resigned from office? To mingle with our helpers? And to be influenced by the stupid communist ideals of the farmers?
What on earth is this? I'm just being supportive of our son.
I'm just giving in to Angelo's whims. So he wouldn't run away. And you, whether you like it or not, you'll go back to being a governor. You will leave the farm to me. Then I'll have to solve all these problems again. Please, Eduardo, I'm begging you. Don't try my patience. I still haven't gotten over all the humiliation you caused. Don't make things difficult. I might just drop everything on you.
It's Christmas, honey. Please don't end it sooner than expected.
Dad, this is Jonathan. He's a catechist. He's the president of Agua Santa Youth for Peace and Development.
A pleasant day, Governor.
Same to you.
Dad, he's the one who introduced me to this kind of outreach program.
Leah told me that a lot of the workers' children are not fortunate enough to go to school. We just want to help them.
Of course. That will definitely help them. I strongly believe that the youth are the hope of the next generation. How can that be possible if they don't have enough education? Am I right?
Your father misses you so much. He wants to see you. Why don't you try and visit them?
Madam Claudia might look for me.
It's Christmas, Ina. You should spend some time with your family.
But, sir...
Don't you want to see your family?
do.
Who are you?
A pleasant day to you, madam. I'm very sorry for the inconvenience, but I would like to ask you a favor.
What do you want?
My name's David. I would like to ask your permission to allow me to visit in court Ina.
You've got the nerve! Have you no shame?
I know, madam. I might be impertinent. I'm very sorry. But I realized if I don't do anything, nothing would happen. I need to do this, so please give me your permission. Because I really love Ina, madam. I'm begging you. Please help me, madam.
Angelo!
Hi, Mom.
Hello.
I'm taking Ina to the farm. I need her to do something for me.
Oh, well, yeah, sure. Why not? That's fine with me.
Thank you.
But, Angelo, I'm afraid Ina can't go with you.
But, Mom, I need her there with me.
Angelo, even if I wanted to, it's not possible.
Why is that?
Because she's got a visitor.
A pleasant day to you, Ina. Ina, are you mad because of what I did?
No, I'm not mad. But you see, I only get to go out whenever Sir Angelo brings me to the farm. I could have seen my family today.
Sir, if we're going to raise the percentage that the workers are getting from the profit of the farm, that would be great, sir. Their life would be well off.
I know. That's life, Uro. You should not waste the chance given to you. Otherwise, you'll lose it and regret everything later.
You're right, sir. That's why they're working doubly hard, because of the chance you're giving them. I know that they will do their best.
You know, being prompt is better than working hard. Also, you should not hesitate, because you can lose what you have without even knowing it.
That's right, sir.
But then again, even if you're prompt, what if she is not meant for you, or she already belongs to someone else, then it's useless.
Sir, are we still talking about your proposal?
Huh?
Is there any problem?
No, there's no problem with the proposal. By the way, what do the workers think about it?
They said that it would be great if they can get a higher percentage from the profit sharing. Their life would be much better, sir.
Ina, I'm really sorry if I bothered you. Would you like me to ask my...
Never mind. She already granted your favor. She'll never give you another one.
I'd ask her again.
What do you really want?
I've made up my mind. I'm not going to be a seaman anymore.
Because of me?
Because I love you.
David, I told you to give me enough time to think about it. Please don't rush me.
Ina. Ina, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry too. Please try to understand my situation. Don't be mad at me. But one thing, I miss the David that I once knew, my childhood friend. David, my playmate. The David who's always willing to listen to my problems.
You know, Mother, if you get to talk personally with Governor Buenavista, you'd know that the people are wrong about him. Mother, you don't believe me, do you?
You know, son, The truth is, I don't really care if what they're saying about the governor is true or not. All I know is what I see and what I feel. And I think Lia is a nice girl. As long as you two get along well together, that would be fine with me. But, son, just remember this. Do not allow anybody to treat you badly or look down on you, no matter who they are.
Miss Belen! Miss Belen! Here, let me help you.
Your mother might be looking for you.
She knows I'm here.
David, is this part of your plan to win Ina's heart?
Yes.
Mother!
Ina! Ina!
I'm glad you're here. Sir Angelo helped me to get out so I could visit you here. Oh, David! What are you doing here?
I'm just helping out.
Come on, what's that supposed to mean?
Why? What's wrong with this? I'm not doing anything wrong. Right, sir?
Good morning, everybody! A pleasant day to you!
Good morning, Sir Angelo.
Mother? How's Father?
He's home right now.
Ina! Ina, wait! Ina! Why? What's wrong? Where are you going? To see Father!
Don't!